should our country end up this strict law and all?
Yeah, I'm also equally happy to be with you at this moment. And your subject is also really good, because you know, it is a need of the day to be answered. As you every day in a newspaper, whenever you open the paper, you just see without any hesitation, I can tell at least one or two crimes against women will be reported repeatedly in all the newspapers. That means the society is yet to reform. What Gandhiji had viewed as a Ramaraja has not yet achieved. Isn't that?
Yes.
So, you may wonder why we are here. Criminals are let loose in churches. It is not the case, I tell you. No? Because we always think of reformative theory. We try to reform a criminal also. Then when the question of reformation comes, the sentence will be not so severe. That is the reason you are seeing that criminals get free nowadays. But now compared to the increase in the crimes, we should send a message to society that we cannot go any longer free like this. Then they have to pay for whatever deeds they do it. And that comes to the thing, I think they need to be punished out of a serious sentencing policy. One more question is whether our laws are sufficient or not. The laws we have in our country is more than adequate to deal with any type of criminals and to sentence them to any extent, including death sentence. That is how we can reform the society.
And moving on to the next question. I would like to know about your judicial career as a high court judge, being a woman.
Being a woman was really wonderful, I tell you, because I enjoyed more privileges. I was never discriminated by anybody because I was a lady. That is how I enjoyed my post very well. And I did my best.
Really marvelous an inspiration to all the women out there, a symbol for women empowerment. So, coming on to the next question. There is this thing, we can't carry on foodstuff in the multiplexes, as majority of them can't afford, you know, the price. So what are your suggestions on this
one? It's really complex, you know. Because when you can afford to go to multiplex theatres, how can you say that you can't afford to buy a bookstore there? That is the first thing. But anyway, I can understand. Because multiplex has got better facilities, people may go with some difficulties also. They have a choice to go, no? So they go. The only idea behind avoiding taking footsteps inside the multiplex theatres is to maintain cleanliness. So I think those people can begin to understand that there is a certain restriction, certain type of foods which cannot spoil the atmosphere, that can be permitted to be carried inside the theatre also.
And I'd like to know about a message on women.
Women empowerment, that is a subject in the day. Whenever we go, they speak of women empowerment. But I tell you, women empowerment, you need not depend upon other men so that you can become empowered. You have to do it by yourself. Women should set her own goal in life to try to achieve this. I think by that she will really empower, and that first will come automatically to her to achieve her whatever goal she says. But in this context, I also like to tell you, in the football field, if you don't have a goal, what happens? You hit the ball into all angles, so it goes for the center spectrum. Likewise, unless you have a goal in life, you cannot achieve anything. So first thing is, the woman, as a being human, she should set a goal in her life, so that she really becomes a goal.
Thank you so much for this wonderful message to all the women out there. And it was really, I spent a really quality time interviewing you. Thank you
so much, Riya, for making me share my views, also interviews with you and others. Thank you.